Hi again. So, how do you cast on? Well, obviously, first of all, you take off the paper wrapping from your wool, and then what we do is we make a loop like that. So we've got like a little loop like that. Then you can thread in one of the needles that you've got, which are 4 millimeter, and all you do is hold the tail, pull it so that it's snug, so you've got it like that. And then to start with, we need to actually be casting on 3 stitches. Now, for cast on, there are many ways to do it. The way that I do it, the way I was taught by my mum, going back many, many years, first of all, you need just to get your tension. So in your right hand, I'm afraid if you're left-handed, you're going to have to do this backwards. But if you're right-handed, hold your fingers out in a fan like that. You're going to wrap the wool twice, the long tail, the one that leads to the wool. You've got a short tail here, which is waste wool, but the long tail that leads to the ball of wool here, you're going to fan your hand, you're going to wrap it round like that, and then this middle finger here, you're going to do it like that. And then when you pick your needle up, if it's a bit loose, which it probably will be to start with, that's not no problem. You just pull it a bit tighter, and that's your tension. Now, obviously, I've been doing knitting a while, so my fingers are quite adept. But if you can see how I've done it, that's how you would do it, right? And then to cast on, you would go, there's your loop. You go in through the front of the loop, and you're using only the tip, only the tip. Don't be doing that. You just want the tip. Okay, and it's gone loose because I've let go now of the tail. You have to make sure that you keep the tension on the other one, because otherwise, like I've just done, it will go. So you need to make sure that that stitch, that first stitch, you keep hold of it so it doesn't go too loose. In the front, around the needle, so you've got your wool at the back here, you take your long tail is at the back, you go round the needle, in, round, peeping, this is how I was taught. Then you can see that needle peep and then pull upwards towards you, and then you go with the left hand needle, you go under that loop, you put your finger on there to keep it in place, and you pull tight, and then you do the same thing in, around, peeping, pull forwards, and then just that's the last stitch. So there's your 3 stitches. Now, I'm hoping that you'll have been able to see how I did that. And then we continue now with the pattern. So, on the pattern for the neck warmer, we cast on 3 stitches. And we're going to be using garter stitch, which is the easiest stitch. So, the first line is knit through the front and then knit through the back. So, you're actually putting 2 stitches out of one you're getting. So we do the same again, we go in through the front, around the needle, and then peeping, pull it towards you a little bit so it's not too tight because it is a bit awkward, and then you go through the back of the same stitch again, in, round, peeping, look at that. And then once you do the last one, you go off, then this one again. We'll do it a different way. You can go in through the back and around. No, you can't do it that way, Jane. Silly Jane. You go in through the front and you go round and you peep. And then I'm hoping you can see this. And then you would go in the back again and round and peeping. And then off. And that is your first row. Right? That's your very first row, so you should get it. It should look something like that. Change hands again, so your stitches are on your left hand side, and the long tail is to the right, and the short tail is to the left. And then what this one is simply knit. So just to knit, we go in through the front, we go round, we peep, and then we go off. And we do the same again, in, round, peeping, off. This is how I learnt with my mum. In, around, peeping, off. In, around, peeping off. So that's it. In, around, peeping off. In, around, peeping off. And don't worry if it's a bit loose, doesn't matter. Because as you progress, it will begin to take shape. So I am now going to continue with those two rows where you knit through the back of the loop, so the front of the loop, then the back of the loop to do your increases, and then just knit one row. So that's basically the start. So I'll see you at the next section where we are going to have to do our buttonhole. Hope all that makes sense. You might have to slow it down a little bit, but that is how you do it. Okay, bye for now.